worthy Grand Chief, officers and members of this grand body, the time has come again for me to give you an account of my stewardship. And I lay before you a detailed account of the transactions of this office, as well as to acquaint you with some of the things necessary to place our order in the front rank with other beneficial associations. Time and conditions change so rapidly that unless we keep on the alert, ever working, ever watching, improving and learning, we will be left behind in the race of progress. Eternal vigilance is a price of success, increasing in membership at a rate which is without precedent in the order, bringing into our ranks men and women of the highest intelligence, the highest standing, character, and to stand and keep on the same old rut would be a positive crime and downright refusal to use those powers, advantages, and opportunities which God has given us to make our order the strongest, the best, and the most beneficial. Since our last meeting, 1,400 new soldiers and 29 more councils are bearing aloft the glorified cross of our patron, Saint Luke. Into this army have come teachers, preachers, lawyers, doctors, businessmen, working men and women. We have invited all, and all have come. The good, the true, the noble, the pure men and women from every rank and every walk of life. But have these come to us simply because they wish us to administer to them in hours of pain and wipe death damp from their brow? When dissolution cometh, then why have they come? They have come hoping and wishing for an opportunity to join hands and still further cement our fraternal band. Shall we disappoint them? Shall we chill the enthusiasm by inactivity? Or shall we bind them stronger and tighter and with the thousands we have and unite the heart, the head, and the hand in the development of our noble order? What do we need to still further develop and prosper us numerically and financially? First, we need a savings bank. Chartered, officered, and run by the men and the women of this order. Let us put our monies together. Let us use our monies to let usury among ourselves, and then we reap the benefit. Shall we no longer continue to bury our talent, which the Lord has given us, and just whack it up in a napkin and hide it away, when it ought to be gaining us other talents? Right worthy Grand Chief, brethren and sisters, let us awake. Let us have a bank that will take the nickels and turn them into dollars. Then, as our patron saint went about doing good, how easily this can be the greatest organization. And let us start doing it now in our ranks. Who is so helpless as a Negro woman? Who is so circumscribed and hemmed in the race of life, in the struggle for bread and meat and clothing as a Negro woman? They're even being denied the work of teaching Negro children. Had this great order, which there are so many good women, willing women, hardworking women, noble women, whose money is here, whose interests are here, whose hearts and souls are here. Can they do something toward giving employment to those who have made it and made it what it is? Oh, brethren and sisters, we need to start and operate a factory for the making of clothing for women and children and men, and a millinery. We have the means. We have the brains, and we're simply waiting for the motion to be made and seconded and carried out, and the order will take a new lease on life. Do not understand that the sick and endowments are to suffer. Let us always, as St. Luke said, as you know, he was our beloved physician, care for the sick and the dying. But at the same time, let us have a bank and a factory. And let our cry be, let us save the young Negro woman. Let us feed and clothe her and give her a chance in the race of life. We need an organ. We need an organ known as a newspaper to herald and proclaim the work of our own. No business, no enterprise which has to deal with the public can be pushed successfully without a newspaper, a trumpet. A trumpet made to sound the orders so that St. Luke upon the mountaintop and that St. Luke dwelling by the side of the sea can hear the same order, keep step to the same music, and march to the same command, although miles and miles will intervene. This paper, begun small, published monthly at first, can be developed into a paper of the order, by the order for which we stand. We have men, we have women, we have brains. So let's form a partnership. Heads, brains, and actually do something. Now, my brethren and sisters, I have faintly outlined and intimated some of the things we ought to do, some of the things we ought to begin now right here at this session. Brethren and sisters, let us arise and be strong and work. And I know the Lord will abundantly bless our efforts.